Have you ever wished you could travel back in time to avoid boring meetings or make a stronger argument the previous week? Although time travel seems to be limited to science fiction, the reality is that we unintentionally journey through time every day. Time, as discovered by Albert Einstein, is not a static concept but rather a constantly moving force that carries us on its unknown journey, to put it in simple terms. As you walk, you're not only navigating space, but also time. In order to simplify this idea, Einstein defines time as the fourth dimension that is combined with three dimensions to form space-time, a cohesive four-dimensional continuum. In terms of space travel, climbing is difficult in the absence of a staircase or an airplane. Maybe, just as we've created ways to travel through space, we still haven't created the ideal time travel device. It doesn't take mysterious materials to solve the time travel puzzle. The secret is found in a spaceship that can approach the speed of light instead. According to Einstein's theory of relativity, time passes more slowly the faster we move across space. Imagine that you are traveling 40 light years away from a potentially habitable exoplanet at 99.9% the speed of light in a spacecraft. You come across primitive life forms and rush back to Earth to share your discovery. But when you get back, you find your coworkers have grown a lot older. Even though it only seemed like 2 years to you, you had been gone for an incredible 80 years from the perspective of the people who live on Earth. Also known as time dilation, you are unlikely to experience this phenomenon due to the present state of technology, which prevents us from traveling at the speed of light. Apollo, our fastest piloted craft to date, traveled at 11,000 meters per second. In order to travel through time, a person would have to accelerate to about 299 million meters per second. In addition, accelerating at that speed would create a tremendous centrifugal force that might tear you apart long before you got close to traveling at light speed. Our bodies just don't seem to be made to handle the intensity of light speed. Wormholes, however, hold out hope. These theoretical tunnels were predicted by Einstein as links between different places and different eras of time, a straight path to a different era and parallel universe. Though no one has actually seen one, the idea of a wormhole is similar to that of a real time-traveling machine. Wormholes are difficult to deal with because they are so tiny, just billions of trillions off of an inch in diameter. If only we could capture a wormhole, we might be able to enlarge it. Imagine a massive tunnel that connects Earth to a different planet. In theory, we could travel back in time by entering a wormhole that had both endpoints at the same place but at different times. Wormholes do provide certain difficulties, though. They are ephemeral, and going back in time would lead to paradoxes. Imagine that you go back in time to convince your grandmother not to get married. As a result, the chain that led to your being is broken when your grandmother fails to give birth to your father. But who would have gone back in time to stop your grandma from marrying your grandfather if you had never been born? Time is a linear that moves only forward. Therefore, we are only able to travel into the future and not the past. Interestingly, in comparison to us, astronauts who live for about a year aboard the International Space Station currently living in the future. Even though it's only going to be 13 milliseconds into the future, their experience shows that time travel is achievable into the future. If wormholes could be studied, they might reveal a completely new world with different laws of physics, one in which traveling back in time is possible. If you had no idea where a time machine would take you, would you have the courage to enter it? In what location and at what time will you choose? Please show your support by liking, subscribing, and leaving your thoughts in the comments if you thought this video was interesting.